Hello everyone, I am Professor M.S. Koite, Assistant Professor of Department of Agricultural Entomology, Kekiwa College of Agriculture, Nashik. So in today's lecture, we are going to learn about the pest of banana under the course number N2243, that is Pest of Horticultural Crops and Their Management. So these are the pest of banana. First one is rootstock weevil, or also called as rhizome weevil. Then second one is pseudostem borer. Third one is fruit rust thrips. Fourth one is aphids. Then fifth one is tingid, or the lacewing bug. And last one is leaf eating caterpillar. So in this lecture, we are going to study only the major pest of banana. So, first pest of banana is root stock weevil or rhizome weevil. So, these are the different life stages of root stock weevil. First one is eggs, then grubs and adult. So, we can see here. So, the scientific name of root stock weevil is Cosmopolite solidus. It belongs to family Curculionidae and order Coleoptera. The host plant of this pest is only on banana. Prefer the varieties like Malbhog and Champa. The oviposition means the site of egg laying in decaying leaf sheath or the rhizome, and the pupation takes place inside the corm and tunneling. The next point is nature of damage of the rootstock weevil. Firstly, the grubs bore into the stem or the sucker. As a result, the affected stem get riddled with the holes while the roots are weakened. Then, bacterial and fungal infection leads to the rotting. With a strong blast of wind, the plants break down from the place of infestation. Later, if the fruits are formed, they are few in a number and inferior in a quality. Both grub and weevil are the damaging stages. So, this is all about the nature of damage by the rootstock weevil. The next point is a control measure or management practices. Firstly, healthy suckers or rhizome should be used for planting. Then do not take a regular crop in the same field to avoid the initial infestation. Then ensure the clean cultivation or follow the sanitation. Then avoid growing Robustum, Kurpurvali, Malbhog, Champa. These are the varieties which are the avoid the growing of such a varieties. Then grow the less susceptible varieties like Pavan, Kadli and Kundan. Then use the Cosmolier trap at the rate of 5 per hectare. Then soil incorporation at the time of planting. Carbofuran 3g 10 gram or the 4-8 10g 5 gram per plant. Before planting, the sucker should be deep in 0.1% quinol phos emulsion. So these are the control measure of the rootstock weevil. Then second and important pest of the banana is pseudostem borer. The scientific name of pseudostem borer is Odoiporus longicollis. It belongs to family Curculionidae and order Coleoptera. The site of egg laying or deposited the eggs on a cut ends of the pseudostem, and the pupation takes place in fibrous cocoon form inside the tunneling. Then next point is nature of damage. Grub bore into the pseudostem making the tunnels and cutting holes on the outer surface. Then exudation of the plants have initial symptoms and blackened mast come out from the bore hole because of the feeding. Then tunnel part decomposes and pseudostem wilts. So this is the nature of damage by pseudostem borer. Then next point is management practices. Remove dry leaves periodically and keep the field clean. Then prune the side suckers every month. Use healthy and pest-free suckers to check the pest incidence. Do not dump the infested materials into the manure pit. Then uproot infested trees, chop into the pieces and burn. So these are the management practices, and this is all about the pseudostem borer of banana. Then third and major pest of the banana is fruit rust thrips. So in first image we can see the fruit rust thrips, and in second image the damaging symptoms on the fruit. The scientific name of the fruit rust thrips is Chitinaphothrips signipennis. It belongs to family Thripidae and order is Hemiptera. Oviposition at stem or under surface of the fruit. The next point is nature of damage. Nymph and adult scrap the surface of the fruits and feed on oozing cell sap. As a result of feeding, the rusty reddish discoloration on the fingers. Then yellowing of leaves and rusty growth over a fruit. This is the nature of damage. And next is management practices. Destroy all volunteer plants and old neglected plantation. Then use healthy and pest-free suckers for planting. Then hot water treatment prior to planting. Then bunches, pseudostem and the sucker should be spread. Then soil application with the fipronil and bifenthrin. So this is the management practices of the thrips. Then next is the aphids of the banana. The scientific name of banana aphids is Pentalonia nigrinorosa. It belongs to family Aphididae and order is Hemiptera. Nature of damage. Sucking cell sap pest cause the serious damage indirectly by acting as a virus and transmitting the bunchy top disease. So this is the important point, that is the banana aphid, that is Pentalonia nigrinorosa, transmitting the bunchy top disease in banana. In case of severe infestation, leaf dwarfing and leaf curling are noticed and fruit bunches become a small. So this is the nature of damage by the banana aphid. So this is also damaging symptoms by the aphids. So in second image, you can see the bunchy top affected plant. Then next point is management practices for the banana aphid. Firstly, selection and planting of disease-free vigorous suckers. Then explant used for the propagation should be indexed. Then production and supply of virus-free plants to banana growers. Then removal and destruction of virus-infected plants as soon as the symptoms are noticed. Then keeping the banana field and surrounding areas weed-free, as certain weeds normally harbor the viruses. Then spraying of banana field with a systemic insecticides of regular intervals to control the insect vectors, such as spraying of 0.05% dichlorovas. Then it is necessary to enforce legal restriction on intrastate movement in order to avoid spread of new banana bract mosaic disease, as it is widely prevalent in southern state. But in other state, the incidence is very minimal. So this is the management practices of banana aphid. This is the predator on banana aphids. So we can use this predator like syrphid. We can use this syrphid fly for the management of banana aphids. So in this image, we can see the egg, larva and adult fly of the syrphid. Thank you.